controlled burning is, first of all, a natural process that has been going on for thousands of years. So when you look at ecosystems like longleaf pine and other southeastern forests, they're adapted to that fire. And so they need that to thin out competing vegetation, to keep the open structure, promote forage for things like turkey and deer and other wildlife. So by burning these low intensity fires every several years, you reduce that fuel, you kill some of the competing vegetation, and you rejuvenate that understory, that grassy herbaceous understory that the wildlife need.
So, but we need to put it on both sides, right?
Let's secure that first,
okay.
And then and if it creeps across, that is
we
fine.
Won't stop
if it doesn't,
it. Okay.
That's fine.
That sounds good. Okay.
There's a lot of planning that goes into this process.
It's a whole science, fire science. You bring in the smoke, the weather, the fuel, the trees, the wildlife. We have to understand all that to be able to use this effectively.
And then when they get out there, we really get their hands dirty. So we go, here's a drip torch. Let's show you how to use it safely. And those techniques all change depending on weather conditions, fuel conditions. What are the safety protocols involved? We kind of take them through the whole process from the planning stages all the way through the mopping up stages.
I've done lab work and I've done field work, so that's really exciting. Learning about it is one thing, but then actually being able to go out and catch things on fire is really, really cool, and it really helps.